that question. Up on fire. We welcome you all to witness the total bull race today. This is the first one since 1976-77. The bull that is standing up there. A group of students. And we thank you all for joining us. We're going to pack the ball from here. About halfway, we're going to have a break. A short break. And then, up to a trick plate. Once the ball is up, we want everyone to proceed here and one last ball. We'll do a celebration.
Thank you. guys okay here?
Oh!
the survivor is just making her way up here. Young. Go ahead. She said she could have packed a pole up herself. Our grandmother, our grandfather, cried for their children that were taken away to residential school. And the children on the other end of the school, they cried for her mother, so they've been punished. Never fed them for a day. I heard all about it, and it hurts me. We love our children. We don't want to start over again. What's that? Okay, the survivor. The survivors will be survivors that are here. We have some waiting across there. They're not able to, not physically to be here. And we're going to brush the pole down.
Laura Michelle, Peter Jim Jr., Ruby Michelle, Cheryl Michelle, Jordan Basil, Mark Tommy, Sandra Patrick, Melvin Madam, Fred Michelle, Mike Thomas, Matt Morse, Amy William, Betty Joseph, Larry Birdstone, Lucy Lorenzen, Evelyn William, Helen Michelle. Beatrice Morse, Lucy Berrigan, Virginia DeWitt, Audrey Muckle, Edward Jim, Margaret LaRose, Shirley Moran, Marcel Madam, Gordy Madam, Roy Morrison, Augustine deceased, Rodney Jack deceased, Michael Nicole deceased, Alfred Mitchell deceased, Jimmy Morse deceased, Mary Donald Morse deceased, Donald Mitchell deceased, Margaret William deceased, Patrick Mitchell deceased, Charlie Pete deceased. These are the survivors and some of the elders. The ones that are deceased that I named went to school with Lucy Verkin at Lijack. Some went to Edmonton, some went to St. Michael's. Earl Mitchell. Masai.
This poll here, we got a funding from Truth and Reconciliation a couple of years ago. And of course, the purpose of this was to honor the survivors. Once the poll is up, we'll get the Master Carver to explain. The survivors had input on what went on the poll. And we've been meeting the last 6 years periodically. And then we met again yesterday, the survivors. Some of them were still a little bit nervous about it. But the ones that are here came here. And we thank you for being here witnessing this. To the survivors, it means a lot just by you being here. You're going to choose their heart. So what they're going to do is they're going to brush it down. And once they've done that, we'll proceed with the poll raise.
I'm just staying for the history of the world.
Everybody, I need a bunch of strong men up here. Alright, anybody with muscles? Here, the ear caught too long, let's go. We have to turn this pole.
Let's go.
After that, that's when you're going to feel the weight. Once that base, once the bottom hits the base of the ground. When the pole hits the base of the mountain, the first very lift is going to be very, very easy. And then you're going to start feeling the weight. That's where you have the mechanical advantage, okay? You ready to go?
There's some bears here. I don't know.
On my count, first lift, it's going to be very easy, like I said, right? And then you're going to feel the tension, then you start pulling, okay? On my count of three, one, two, three, high!
Go wider. Buddy, someone's in.
At the bottom of the pole, we have a caribou small frog, Laxiliu crest, that represents, this is Laxiliu territory that the pole went up on. And above that, we have four children crying, sitting around the pole, that represents four generations of residential school that suffered during the days of the residential school era. Above that, we have a 6-foot empty space that represents a void in culture and language that happened to the people who suffered their time at residential school. And then after the 6-foot space, we have the four same children. They have different looks on their face. They have a smile. They have a semi-smile on their face. They're heading towards, they're all crawling up towards a chief. The chief is a Dai, chief of chiefs. He's got on his full regalia, apron, button blanket, headdress. The chief has got his hands out, welcoming the children back to the culture and the language. Above that, we have the eagle in full flight. The eagle represents freedom and forwardness for the Wet'suwet'en people and courage. Aotse, Mesa.
Are you riding it?